feet affect our arm strength.
Live show.
Absolutely not. We do not accept payment. This Bye. Is about art. Ladies and gentlemen, the Whistling World is filled with tales of courage,
Gallantry.
Friendship, hope, and explosions. What? Oh, immense love. Tales come from a man who lived over 500 years ago.
His name was Fiddle the Bard, and he had one of the most luxuriant beards.
Samuel, I hardly really care about his beard.
His luxuriant beard? Truth be told, I would wager Ringard's vault stacked with galleons that there is not a child raised in the Whistling World today who doesn't know about Fiddle the Bard.
What about the Orlocks, Harry Hart?
The wizard from the Hobbling Pot.
Gabby and Shayla are on the ride.
Let's do what we came here to do. What's that? Right. Theatre. Places. Well, what story are we telling?
Garnet.
Gentlemen, this tale is undoubtedly one with which you may be familiar. It concerns the fortunes of three brothers.
Wait!
What is it now?
Can I play one of the brothers? I never get to do it. I'm always, you know.
You can be the second brother, but be careful.
I'm always careful.
My fellow witches and wizards, everyone ready? We now present to you the tale of the three brothers. There were once three brothers who were traveling along a lonely, winding road at twilight. In time, the brothers reached a river too treacherous to pass, but being learned of the magical arts, they simply waved their wands and made a bridge. Before they could cross, however, they found their path blocked by a hooded figure. It was death. And he felt cheated because travelers usually drowned in the river. But death was cunning. He pretended to congratulate the three brothers upon their magic and said that each had earned a prize for having been clever enough to evade him. The eldest brother, who was a combative man, asked for a wand more powerful than any in existence. A wand that must always win duels for its owner. So Beth fashioned him one from an elder tree that grew nearby.
The second brother, who was an arrogant man, decided that he wanted to humiliate death still further and asked for the power to recall others from death. So Death picked up a stone from the riverbank and gave it to him.
Finally, Death turned to the third brother, a humble and wise man who did not trust Death. So he asked for something that would enable him to go forth from that place without being followed by Death. And Death, most unwillingly, handed over his own cloak. Visibility. In due course, the brothers separated, each for his own destination. The first brother travelled to a distant village, where he sought out a wizard with whom he had once quarrelled. Naturally, with the elder wand as his weapon, he could not fail to win the duel that followed, leaving his enemy a pawn. The eldest brother proceeded to an inn, where he stayed loudly of the powerful wand he had snatched from how it made him invincible. But that very night, another wizard crept upon the oldest brother as he lay upon his bed, whereupon he stole the wand and with it the brother's life. So Death took the first brother for his own.
Meanwhile, the second brother took the stone that had the power to recall the dead and turned it thrice in hand. To his amazement and his delight, the figure of the girl he had once hoped to marry before her untimely death appeared at once before him. Yet soon she turned sad and cold, but she did not belong in the mortal world. Driven mad with hopeless longing, the second brother took his own life, so as truly to join her.
And so Death took the second brother for his own. As for the third brother, Death searched for many years, but he was never able to find him. It was only when
age.
The youngest brother shed the cloak of invisibility and gave it to his son.
Coming out of the ride. Wow, it's really hot.
Thank you.